tornado that struck Xenia, Ohio had something in common with all natural disasters. It changed the lives of those who lived through it. NBC's Floyd Kalber spoke with some of Xenia's residents, starting with one young boy who, it's safe to say, has never forgotten the terror of 74.
Mark Huffman lost his school. He was at home when the tornado hit, and that's something he'll never forget.
There's been a lot of trees in, there was a lot of trees in Xenia, and we'd have a lot of the birds, and as a matter of fact, out here in our backyard, we had a set of blue jays and a set of cardinals, and the squirrel that climbed the tree. But when we came out, you know, we couldn't even find our own cats. There was no birds. All there were was people and trash everywhere. And you might see a bird lying on the ground, but it, you know, wouldn't be alive. It was scary, no animals, nothing.
Wonder where they all went to?
A lot of the birds, I think, were picked up by the tornado. Some friends of ours that lived just out of town were watching it and said they saw birds fluttering right into telephone poles. They couldn't control themselves. So I guess a lot of them just gave up.
You know, it's kind of hard for me to imagine what this place was like before, you know?
Oh, it was beautiful. You'd pull up in front of the house, and there were big, beautiful pillars holding up the roof. It was beautifully trimmed in green paint with green siding. As you walked in the front door, and there's a piano, and then two big sliding doors that would open, and that would lead you into the living room with blue shag carpet, a nice, big, beautiful mirror above a fireplace that was oak trimmed. Chandelier hanging in the middle. You know, one of the old type radiators.
What was the kitchen like?
It was nice kitchen. It had a pantry to keep canned goods and stuff. It was nothing fancy. But it was a place to eat. In my room, the thing I liked most about it was the bed. My mom had just made me a comforter. And I liked to just lay there and, you know, maybe look through a book. And it was nice. I liked it. It was probably about my favorite spot.
Despite everything that's happened, you're a pretty lucky family, aren't you? I mean, you didn't lose anybody.
Yeah. I think we lost a couple friends, but, you know, my parents' friends. And it was a breakdown to lose the business in the house. But otherwise, we were pretty lucky. We never would have made it if Dad hadn't have called. He came running in the door at 5 o'clock. He doesn't even know how he got here. He just ran. And he walked in the house and yelled, and I said, hello. That's all I knew to say. And we didn't know where anybody else was. You know, there wasn't any time for, say, oh, hello, Dad, I'm so glad you're alive. I could think it, but, you know, I couldn't say it because we had to find everybody else. There's time for that later.
Well, is there anything that sticks in your mind about this whole thing?
There's nothing really that sticks in my mind except for, you know, the destruction of the house. We're going to tear it down. I'm going to be homeless, so that's about the only thing I ever think of.
Do you feel like you really want to hold on to your mom and dad now? I mean, is it more than you did before? Is that a...
I think I need them more than I probably ever did before. And both my sisters. I don't think I could have lived without either, any of them. I've been kind of scared for the past couple of weeks. I haven't been sleeping good. Like, you know, I'll go to bed at 11 o'clock, and at 6 o'clock in the morning, I'll be all over the bed. I can't get comfortable, and probably most of it's probably worn off, but there's, you know, kids are still don't want to go to bed. They're afraid that maybe another one's gonna come, or maybe they just won't wake up again. They just don't know what to think. It's really scary, and they probably feel the same way.
Do you think that's going to wear off, or do you think that's going to be something they're going to have to live with for the rest of their
life? It might be a while before it wears off completely, but it'll be something that everybody, I think, will remember. And I know I'm going to tell my grandchildren.
There's no way to ever replace buildings like you see here. They're, you know, they're from another age, another time. As you can see some of this around here, I don't think it's dawned on the people yet how stark some of this is going to look when we do finish.
I just wonder how you feel personally in something like this.
Well, it's a personal tragedy. And each and every person that comes to us, we listen to them and try to help them all we can, but then we got to go ahead and do our job also. We do both to our best of our ability.
Debris was carted out of Xenia to a quarry north of town. 285,000 truckloads, half the town. A man and his little boy watched. The man said he just wanted to see where they put his house.
In the summer of 74, the people of Xenia discovered something inside themselves, something not unlike the determination and the spirit of the early pioneers. So they cleaned up the rubble and they began to rebuild their city, refusing to let nature have the last word.
That's a lesson taught by floods, earthquakes, hurricanes, as well as tornadoes. Nature always has the last word. The people of Xenia, Ohio, wasted little time putting their lives and homes back in order. Just 6 months after the town had been leveled, 90% of all property damage claims had been settled. Things weren't quite back to normal, but they were getting there.
Just 6 months ago, this neighborhood looked like Hiroshima, but this block has been rebuilt and many others like it. To date, just 6 months later, more than 50% of the tornado victims are back in Xenia, living in their permanent homes. Crailer Manufacturing, the city's largest employer, was totally destroyed. Crailer could have abandoned Xenia, but the company decided it owed something to its employees. Loyalty.
We did have a lot of discussion as to whether it would be rebuilt or not. But after weighing all the factors, we've decided that Xenia, Ohio is where it's going to be rebuilt.
How were you at the beginning?
Very emotional. Very emotional. No doubt about it. It's been quoted in some of the news media and so forth. I was openly weeping sometimes. But it was a trying thing. It really was.
You really care about these people, don't you?
I do. Really.
So you're going to stay?
I sure am. Yes, sir. Forever.
Smaller businesses began coming back. A new restaurant opened, and the owners donated the first day's profits to the Xenia Disaster Relief Fund. The corner pharmacy reopened on Main Street after extensive repairs. Its owner, Tuffy Snyder, felt he had come out all right with the help of his insurance man and the SBA. So far, SBA has loaned Xenia's businessmen $10 million at 5% interest. Xenia also got a federal grant to operate 19 new minibuses and test a new experimental public transportation system for the government, trying out a system that might be adopted in other small cities. The fare is 25 cents. The Xenia Gazette finally had some good news to print. The urban renewal plan was drawn up and agreed to by the people within the 60-day deadline. The city had sent the Department of Housing and Urban Development the plan and a request for a $3.5 million grant and a $2 million loan to rebuild the downtown section. The plan was reviewed and approved in exactly 10 days. Xenia got enough money to open the schools on schedule. Some students are in temporary modular classrooms. High school and junior high school students are using the same school on a split session basis. But most Xenia children are back in Xenia schools. Enrollment is down only 2%. Mark Huffman is back with his old classmates. His father is still selling cameras out of a trailer, but he's looking for a new shop. The Huffman home is long gone, but Dick and Jackie plan to build a new one in the old North End, a few doors down from the Smiths. Late this summer, grass finally began to grow in the vacant lots downtown. Weeds and wildflowers helped soften the desolation. This autumn, 2,000 students returned to Central State University's devastated campus. The school, like the trees, is determined to survive and flourish. It's getting federal money to rebuild. Next spring, here in downtown Xenia, they will begin building the new downtown with a modern shopping mall that most people wanted.
Xenia, Ohio has come a long way since the tornado struck. Many homes have been rebuilt. One way or another, the children are back in school and there is hope for the future. But soon, winter will be here, and the people of Xenia know it will be dreary and in many ways discouraging. The government has provided plenty of money, but it'll be a long time before construction begins downtown. Soon the leaves will begin to fall and the frost will kill the weeds. Vast stretches of desolate ground will stretch out into the low winter skies. Anyone passing here will never be able to forget what was lost on April 3rd, 1974. Someone once described winter as a tunnel, a dreary passageway you have to get through to make it from autumn to spring. It'll be a long, hard winter for the people of Xenia, but they know that. And from what we've seen of them, we think they'll make it through. Floyd Calber, NBC News.